do for empowering kids. We've got a few selected parents that are going to come on stage, and Mr. Khan is going to ask them a few questions on what they are doing for empowering their children or children in school, etc. May I please request for the parents to come on stage?
From amongst you. And I wanted to ask them, oh, such beautiful parents. Good. Only ladies, all the mothers are here. So I'm going to ask them a few questions, because the whole idea is of this evening is to be able to empower children, is to kind of, and she's telling, okay, empowerment later, quickly take the picture first. Okay, let me do the picture in the center first, so then we... Okay, I've been given some questions to ask you, otherwise I would just dance with you. But we have to make it look that we're serious about children, because parents need to know. Okay, this is about empowering. One of the aspects that comes to fore, and we all think our children are unique. Tell me, how do you think your child is unique, and how do you help him develop that uniqueness?
He's my child, so he's unique.
Yeah, if I ask too difficult a question, you can always tell me. I know it's difficult to be on stage and answer stuff and all,
yes,
but don't worry.
In front of you.
No,
yes.
No, don't worry. I'm more harmless than I look.
I love you, Shah Rukh.
Okay, thank you very much.
Okay, my child, Vatsal Gada, honestly, the uniqueness is that he's very creative and he thinks out of the box. So that's what even I like, because any open house or anything, the teacher always tells me, he can never write a by-hearted answer. He'll always write it in his own words. He's very good at making poems. So that's what I always encourage. Read a lot. And it's okay, put it in your own words, as long as the essence is there. So you can be creative. I'm happy he's creative in studies. I wish it takes him far. Thank you.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. I think that's very important, that you allow your child to answer questions the way he or she wishes to, because... my kid does it, you know this is the right answer, but he says there's a point of view. He gets zero also sometime, which is also all right. But at least he has been given the opportunity to express himself. Fantastic. And I love you too. Sorry, what's your name, ma'am?
Meghna.
Meghna. Okay, the question to you is, what kind of conversation do you have in front of your child? With your husband, with your parents, friends? Are there any limitations, or you can talk anything? And how old is your baby first?
I would like to tell you something first before I answer this question. I learned so much from you, because when I shot English Babu Desi Name with you, I was just 12 years old, and you made me a good human being. You taught me dancing and everything, like how to be on sets. And hats off to you. Because of you, I am here.
And thank you. Now you make me feel very old also. She was only 12 years old then. See?
Yeah, I used to call you Bijuria. I mean, my name was Bijuria in that film, and I used to call you Shah Rukh Uncle.
Okay. Don't call me Shah Rukh Uncle today, please.
So, kids, they learn from us. They observe us. I tell her the difference between positive and negative behavior most of the time. And, that is there in my conscious that she's around me. So most of the time I talk to her in kids' voice, okay?
Ye acha hai, ye acha nahi hai.
So she learns from us. So I make sure that she knows the difference between positivity and negativity. So the conversations are most of the time very positive.
But like have you had that occasion when you're talking adults and the kid walks into a conversation which may be embarrassing for them? Do you allow that to continue? Do you explain things openly? Have the times changed so much that you say, okay, this is what we are talking about, and this is the amount that you're supposed to know right now? Not yet.
No, I've never done that. I mean, I make sure that I change topic, or I make sure she's in a different room, but I never explain that.
Okay, I think mothers are gentler. I think fathers should do that. If there is a topic which needs to be touched upon, which is a little iffy, I think you can perhaps go ahead and, explain it to them quietly in their own way.
Next time I'll try that.
Yeah, okay. Thank you so much. Can I know your name, please?
Kamal.
Kamal.
Kamal. Okay, Kamal. And how old is your baby?
She's 11.
11 years old. And where does she study?
ABM Juhu.
Sorry, yeah. And keep it closer. Yeah. Okay, Kamal, the question to you is, does your kid get time to be a kid? Or like parents do, we all do, we make this mistake, we push them too hard to keep on working. But does he get time to be a kid?
as a parent, I try to ensure she gets enough time as a kid. And I think this place has been a boon because at every given opportunity, my daughter wants to be here. And I think this is the best place where they can be a kid without any kind of pressure.
Thank you, Kamal. Yeah, we'll... And this is your baby?
Yeah.
How old is she?
She's six.
Six?
She's Naisha. Naisha.
Naisha. Hi, Naisha. How are you?
I'm fine.
Okay, I'm going to ask your mom some questions. So if she doesn't say the truth, tell us, okay? how often do you compliment your child and reward your child? Are you complimentary? I'm not talking about just being madly in love with our children as we are, because we think our kids are the best. But beyond that, if they do something right, do you sit down, compliment them? And specifically because I love girls, I do compliment my daughter a lot, from beauty to work. So do you compliment on their achievements and stuff?
Shahrukh, I love you. Okay, I just want to tell you that first. I just love you. And yes, I do compliment her and I do reward her. I tell her that she's a princess and I tell her that she's very beautiful. We have this reward chart at home where she gets gold stars for doing all the right things she does. And I guess we've learned this from our parents that none of us are perfect. And it's always nicer to highlight their, don't look at me, I love you.
Thank you, dear. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Before, can you say hi to my son, Arhan, there?
Hi. How are you? Oh, how beautiful is he?
Mashallah. Thank you.
Okay. What's your name, ma'am?
My name is Neha.
Neha.
Yeah.
Neha. And how old?
Rajwanshi.
Sachi.
Sakshi.
Sakshi. And Sakshi, what's her name?
What's her name?
Vedika.
Vedika. Hi, Vedika. How are you? How old are you, Vedika?
Answer?
Okay. It's all right. You don't have to, girls don't have to tell their age at all. Okay, Sakshi, I'd like to ask you, how would you like your child, Vedika, to reflect you? Because it is said that children are a reflection of their parents. Is there something, and would you be too tough about it, that she has to grow up to be like me, or would you be easy about it and let her have her own personality?
I'm a very easy mother. I let her do whatever she wants to. But yes, I want her to be like us, the way me and my parents reflect our parents.
So yeah, this, I think that's a very important aspect. People sometimes, my kids tell me, you're very old-fashioned and boring. But I think there is some truth and there is some importance in traditions that we've been brought up in. I think we just need to modernize them and reintroduce the values. I think we should all make an effort to even reintroduce the values in a cooler, nicer way. Perfect. So you got to learn the words they speak and talk to them in the way. I think I think each parent and each teacher, I think, is very right in thinking that their parents, children should grow up to be in their images as long as you're not a bad parent, right, which very few of us are. So we should try and do that, and you should encourage that. Yeah. I'm so thankful for all you ladies to be here and having answered this.
One more thing. I tell my daughter always that I'm your first teacher, I'm your first best friend.
Absolutely, yeah, so that's important
that
to be the best
what
friend.
I'm inviting
you. Vedika, you heard that?
Sakshi.
Okay. No, okay. That's very cool to call her Sakshi. Okay. What's her nickname? How do you call her otherwise if you don't call her Sakshi?
Who's your first friend?
Who's your best friend?
By the way, she calls you Manwa uncle.
Manwa uncle.
Manwa uncle. Manwa lage.
She's starting young. And see, all of you, you also call me uncle. I've only got these uncle kind of girls liking me. I need to find older women. I need to find women my age now. Okay. Yeah,
thank you, ladies. Thank you, Mr. Khan. We have a signature campaign where we pledge our oath to making the world a better place. So we'd like Mr. Khan to lead the campaign, signature campaign, to sign the board along with the ladies and other parents.
Please come. I'll be the ladies, but I'll start because, you know, the whole idea of this evening was to be able to say to everyone, spread the word through the media, through everyone, that it's important to empower your children. Don't treat your children just like kids and control them and let them not open up, be independent, have freedom. I think the pledge tonight, at least on my side, is of empowering them and allowing them to make informed decisions. After that, if they go wrong, parents are there, mothers are there, teachers are there to take care. If they go right, the decision is theirs and I think it gives them a little more freedom. So my pledge today is, On notebooks, my handwriting is better, so please don't judge me, okay? There you go. You also can do a pledge, what you'll allow your kids to do.
The board is going to be outside. I request all parents to please sign the pledge with their theory of empowerment and how they
make their own informed decisions. And why I say own, because if they make it wrong, we are there as parents and teachers to make sure that the information is given to them and correct them if they go wrong. But allow them to go wrong. I really believe children should be allowed to go wrong, because otherwise, I don't think they will ever figure out what is the right way to go. Sometimes we overprotect. Ye nahi karo, wo nahi karo, wo galat hai, ye theek hai, gir jaoge. I think how, as the kid is growing up, learning to walk, we allow them to fall a bit so they know it's not good to fall. I think we need to allow them to have their own informed decisions. That's what I mean. This coming up.